Imagination, cultivation. So often we look to our neighbor for direction and we don't live from our own center. And because of that, we're constantly waiting for affirmation or confirmation or consolation when it comes to our brilliant quote unquote ideas or lack thereof, expecting those ideas to be the ones that stick around, are indelible and perennial. But the truth of the matter is it's not the way it works. It's the exact inversion of such. When we choose to live from our own center, listening to our own imagination and cultivating that, regardless of how it's perceived, if we go according to what we've conceived, that's where the brilliance comes from. It's not in getting confirmation from anyone else. It's in choosing to let it, like you harvest it with your sickle, you yield the glowing crops that are sprouting forth after being germinated in the subconscious soil. That's how it works. And then the population responds, because that which is most universal starts out with what's most personal. So if you do what's most personal, that will ring psychic cherries in a way that is genuinely bona fide universal. So I want to talk to you about imagination cultivation. Are you cultivating your imagination? Or are you just listening to everyone else, what everyone else is saying? Like, are you a boiling pot? Are you a boiling pot? Like, I want to be somebody who cultivates my imagination. That's really on my heart to do this. So the ancient Romans, they believed something powerful about imagination. They believed that Consus was the god of secret counsel. He was also the god who protected the harvest. He protected the grain. He was represented by a seed of grain, because that's what the secret counsel is. It starts off as a mere seed. It's protected by the deity. And what happens as it germinates, as you let it marinate, to mix up the metaphor, then what happens? It begins to grow, it begins to burgeon, and it starts to flourish. But it all starts with this secret counsel in your mind, represented by a grain seed, the secret counsel of Consus. He was the god of the conceptual, the god of the imagination, the god of the subconscious counsel, or the imagination inside. Very, very important stuff. So be that as it may, Consus was a very fascinating ancient archaic Roman deity, because they believed that when an idea spontaneously grew in a person's mind, you know who was the culprit behind it? It was Consus. It was the secret counsel of Consus. When an idea just spontaneous, like instantaneous, cropped up and popped up, dropped by and stopped by in places and spaces in your conscious mind for the subconscious, like that was engineered and prompted by Consus. He was the culprit behind it. So very simply, the ancient Romans believed that when an idea spontaneously grew in a person's mind, Consus was the culprit behind planting the germ of said concept, Consus, counsel, secret counsel of that idea, particularly and more specifically when the plan sped well and when they proved to be efficacious and effective and efficient. So when a plan sped well, like when a plan prospered, who was the culprit behind it? Who was the engineer of this idea? Who was the citizen of the imagination? It was Consus. Additionally, the Romans believed in these spirits called genii. Think of like a genie who grants you wishes. Well, a genii was a group, a conglomeration of spirits that represented states and represented individuals. So the singular of genii is what? Genius. So a genius, like a genie, is a safeguarding spirit. And the ancient Romans, and this goes perfect with Consus, they believed that every individual had their own special, particular, and specific genius. So that's kind of cool, because it means everybody does have something to offer if they'll listen to the counsel of Consus. So they believed that a spirit called a genius tagged along and really accompanied you wherever you went. So your genius would aid you through your earthly career. Your genius would console and comfort you during times of grief, sorrow, sadness, bereavement, etc. And your genius would also prompt you to the doing of valiant deeds and semnos, noble acts for the annals. So that's what the genius would do. The genius would prompt you to do noble deeds and honorable deeds. It would comfort you when you were sad. And your genius would also, very importantly, your genius would aid you throughout your earthly career, throughout your earthly campaign. And they believed, the ancient Romans did, that everybody had their genius. So it's very similar, by the way, to the modern day concept of a guardian angel, because a genius, the genii, were winged creatures. Think of how a genie seems to float, right? They were winged creatures. So genius, genie, guardian angels, your daemon, like it all has the, they all have these similar sort of archetypes, as it were. So every person, if every person has their own special genius, what that means for us is that, well, we can sickle and glean applications here. What that means is when the grain of an idea is effectively and essentially developed in our minds, we best water it and let it grow. Who knows what the metaphorical consus and the poetical genius are up to? Who knows what they're cooking up in our minds? So let your brain storm, ride the lightning, and then capture it in a bottle. Chase down ideas. Don't put away your spade. Keep digging. Don't ignore your genius. Water the thought given you by consus. Cultivate concepts, because brilliant and glowing harvests of imagination are yours for the reaping. Brilliant and glowing harvests of imagination are yours for the gleaning. So can I encourage you to cultivate your imagination? Like, I think a lot of times we're just listening to so many different voices, and especially in the 21st century, the internet has become an echo chamber where we're constantly hearing like the same sort of cultish ideas. But if instead we'll say, okay, how can I, through imagination cultivation, heed the secret counsel and concept of consus, so that any idea that speeds well, I know the culprit behind it lurks somewhere in the divine realm. What if I said, you know what, I'm going to listen to my archaic Roman genius, and I'm going to receive consolation during times of sadness. I'm going to be somebody who believes my earthly career is going to be aided by this ever accompanying genius who tags along. What if we said, just like the ancient Romans did, I believe that my genius wants me to do the daring of deeds and the saying of words, noble acts and heroic feats on the field. Like, that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. And the ancient Romans believed every single one of us had our own special genius. So there are concepts that we can cultivate and sickle and harvest and yield if we won't just listen to what everybody else is saying, if we won't just go into the boiling pot or the echo chamber of all the opinions that are being spewed out, and instead we decided, you know what, I have my own special genius, so I'm gonna live from my own interior world, and I'm not gonna look to the peripherals in the extraneous or exteriors to guide me.